All right, Lopez. We're headed for the station. We'll see you there. Let's go.
Here to here. Now, if they're coming across the front that wide, I can't possibly stop them. I just don't have enough men.
Well, when morning comes, they'll hold up. We should have a better chance to handle them.
But the city will be a disaster area by that time. They only move at night.
Sheriff, you were saying something about a fence.
Yeah. Fence about 2 miles long and 20 feet high. Look.
How far do you think those rabbits travel with each stride?
Oh, judging from the tracks we've seen, I'd say, four, maybe 5 feet.
You think that railroad dispatcher is still on duty?
He should be, unless he's been evacuated.
Why don't you see if you can get him on the telephone?
We'll funnel him into a half-mile area at the tracks.
Unless you tell me those rabbits are good at climbing ladders, I got no intentions of budging out of this place. Now, what can I do for you?
According to the map, the railroad line north of town cuts clear across, east and west. Is there any way we can isolate a stretch of track at least 2 miles long between us and Galanos?
Well, there's a side and 5 mile east of here. I'll switch the one to the east right now. I got the tracks to the east cut off from the rest of the line. There's a freight on the line. I can stop it, throw the switch if you want, but...
No, it won't work with the train on the track.
What won't work?
A fence, Major. A fence between the rabbits and the city. An electrical fence.
We'll electrocute them on the railroad tracks.
Now, as soon as that train clears that other switch, I want you to throw it open the same way. You got that?
Right.
Attention! Ladies and gentlemen, attention! There is a herd of killer rabbits headed this way, and we desperately need your help. Roll up your windows. Turn on your lights and follow the police car at the entrance of the theater. Please keep calm and cooperate with the authorities. Do you read me?